So hey everyone, today I'm going to be showing you how to make a cutout transition just like this on Premiere Pro. For your information, I'm going to be using the Sapphire and BCC plugin, but you don't need any plugins. They are completely optional if you're going to make the warp transition and also the zooms. These are my clips, and what I'm going to be doing is using the second one to create the cutout. So head to your first frame, you want to right click and select insert frame hold segment. So that's going to turn it into a single image, or should I say a separate layer of that single frame. So you can, it works as a image. You can move it around, do anything, add effects. But what we're going to do is create a mask around it. So head over to opacity, click the pen tool, and what I'm going to do is just create a mask. It's really that simple, basic editing stuff. So I'm going to zoom in. Then what I'm going to do is start from the very bottom and make my way around. Okay, now that's done, I'm just gonna decrease the mask to around 2 and the mask expansion to negative 0.5. So this is how it looks. In fact, I might decrease the mask feather. Yeah, I think one looks fine with these settings. So I'm gonna cut this down and place it above my first clip and extend the duration so it matches the bottom layer. Then what I'm gonna do is nest this cutout. So you want to right click, head over to nest and click OK. Now you could use the motion to create the pop-up animation. However, we want some motion blur, especially if you're going to be using a lower sequence frame rate. So I'm using 30, which means ideally I would want some motion blur. If I was using 60, then you know, you don't really need any motion blur. It's pretty smooth with no motion blur, but I'm using 30. So what I'm going to do is search for transform underneath distort, and I'm going to add it onto the cutout. Then head back into effect controls, keyframe the position at the start, and I'm going to push the character down. Then I'm going to head to the last frame and reset or adjust it so that it's centered. Then open up the graph, so click on the arrow next to the stopwatch and just copy my graph. First of all, I'm going to move this keyframe ahead because for some reason it doesn't work properly if it's all the way back at the first frame. So I'm just going to graph it like this. Starts off fast and slows down. Then I'm going to highlight both of these, right click, head over to spatial interpolation and select linear. Otherwise you might have some issues. So I'm just going to push this keyframe back and see how this looks. Perfect. Now we need motion blur. So what you can do is increase the shutter angle. I wouldn't recommend going higher than 90 because it looks terrible. So if I max it out, yeah, it looks terrible. I'm pretty sure anyone with eyes can tell. So I'm going to keep it at 90, which is just about enough motion blur. Then I'm going to move this keyframe all the way to the end. So yeah, that's all done. I'm now going to move my clips forward. I'm just going to ripple delete. So here's how it looks so far. That's everything done with the cutout. You can add flashes, you can add zooms now. So first of all, I'm going to begin by adding BCC Ripple Dissolve directly onto my clip because I don't think it works on an adjustment layer. So what I'm going to do is change the animation to percent done and keyframe it to 0 at the start, head to the last frame and increase it all the way to 100. Then I'm going to graph it. So open up the graph. I'm going to use the top graph. So I'm going to expand this. I'm going to highlight both these keyframes, right click and select Bezier. I'm going to move this forward and graph like this. So in fact, I'm going to head one frame ahead. Or should I move this back? Let me just try this. Move this back. And I'm going to keep this around 25. So I'm just going to adjust this. That looks about, that looks fine. But I do need that to be around 20. In fact, let me just push that back. Maybe somewhere around here. 26 should be okay. So this is how it looks. I'm just going to push this all the way to the end. And this is how the ripple dissolve looks, which is very nice. Now I'm going to add zooms. So project. I'm going to right click new item adjustment layer and click OK, place it on top. I'm going to be using blur mode curves, which is part of Sapphire. So as I said, if you don't have these plugins, you can just use transform as an alternative, which is, you know, slightly harder. So I prefer using these plugins. I'm going to add S blur mode curves onto the adjustment layer. And what I'm going to do first of all is move the center XY up. So let's go for 250. So I'm going to keyframe the Z dist and then head to the last frame. Let's set it to 0.8 maybe, or maybe 0.9, something lower. Yeah, that looks fine. Then I'm going to keyframe it. This is going to be a little bit tricky, so I'm going to head one frame back and use the velocity to help me. If you do need help, so if you want a more detailed tutorial on these zooms, then you can check out this video here. It's in the description below. I go into more depth on how to create smooth zooms using blur mode curves. For your convenience, I've dropped it in the description below, so check it out if you're interested. Anyways, I'm going to drag this keyframe all the way to the left. Make sure it's around zero. Perfect. So I'm going to push this back. And also what I might do is push this back as well. Yeah, okay, that looks fine. So what I'm going to do now is create a reverse version. I'm going to minimize this and add it again and set this one to 250 for the Y axis, and then keyframe the Z dist, head to the end and set this to around, let's go maybe 0.8. Yeah, that looks great. So I'm going to graph this and this time to the other side, watching the velocity. So I'm going to put it down to zero. Perfect. And I'm going to tighten this up a little. Then I'm going to push it all the way to the end. I don't usually do that, but I think for a transition like this, it might look good. Might look very smooth. So it looks like this. Okay, I'm going to minimize this. One more effect I'm going to add on is flash. I'm just going to use one from my premium preset pack, which also does include both of these effects. So these ones I've just made here are zoom ins. There are also zoom outs, but also there are flashes. So this one right here, I'm just going to add that on. And I think it just saves a lot of time. So if you're interested and you want to grab 50 presets in total, including slides and transitions, effects and one framers, all that kind of stuff, then you can check it out in the description below. But anyways, this flash effect here, very simple. It's just Lumetri color with the exposure keyframed to 4 at the start and then 0 at the end. That's it. Really that simple. So what I'm going to do is duplicate this over to my other clips, and this is the result. Oh, it lagged there. Let me try that again. This is the result. Perfect. Anyways, that's it for this tutorial. If you're interested, then check out this video here. Otherwise, thank you very much for watching, and thank you to my members for their monthly support as always. I'll see you in the next video. Peace.